Hello, everyone. My name is Thomas Healy. I'm the founder and CEO of Hyliion. And today I'm here to talk about electricity. And hopefully many of you have experienced this of you need a lot of electricity in order to power these EVs. And we're going to talk about a new way of thinking, a way where we think the future is you make your own power on site as opposed to being reliant on the grid. So with that, you can actually see our power module on the slide here to my left. And these are designed to be your prime power solution. So think about a facility. Right now it has an air conditioning system outside. Well, we think the future is, in addition to having an AC system, your facility will also have a power plant sitting right outside, providing all the power that you need. Now that unravels a lot of questions, like can you make electricity as efficient as the grid? Is it reliable? What's the cost of it? So we're going to cover all of that, but we believe that with our technology breakthrough with this KARNO modular power plant, you now actually have the ability to feasibly make your own power and be more economical than buying from the grid. So let's dive into it a little about what are the applications where we see making your own power makes sense. So the first is EV charging. This is something that over the last few years I've talked about at ACT Expo, which is plugging in 10 of these electric semi-trucks into the grid consumes the same amount of electricity as the entire Super Bowl stadium during game time. So when you think about going out and deploying an EV charging site, this isn't just an easy equation of asking your utility for a grid interconnect and you're going to have the power easily available. That's not the case. These trucks can consume a tremendous amount of power. And then when you couple that with there's a massive increase in power demand happening across many industries right now, one of the main ones being with AI and data centers. And so as we just shared earlier today in our product unveil, data centers, the latest and greatest data centers being built, their amount of energy consumption is actually 100x the amount of plugging in 10 EV semi-trucks. So that's equivalent to 1,000 trucks would be the same as one data center. Now that unravels a lot of questions around like, well, who's willing to pay more for the electricity? And from the numbers we've seen, the reality is data centers are gonna win every day in that equation. The amount they're willing to pay for electricity and the need for powering these computers is huge, and it's a situation where they will come to the table and be willing to pay more. We're already seeing that happen in the oil and gas space, where there are companies who provide modular power plants into oil and gas, and data centers are coming in and saying, we'll pay you double what the oil and gas providers are paying to steal those generators and bring them to power an AI data center. And then the last part where we think distributed grids make a lot more sense is, if you look at our utility today, 60% of the transmission lines in the US are already at their end of life or past their end of life expectancy. And so either we gotta go build a bunch more power plants and then build a bunch of transmission lines to bring the power to the end destination, or what we think is going to happen is we move to this model of make your own power on site. So a little bit of background on Hyliion. I founded the company back in 2015. We are headquartered in Austin, Texas. We are listed on the New York Stock Exchange, the American Exchange, and then we also have an R&D facility up in Cincinnati. The origin there is, you know, some of you might be familiar with us from years past of being a powertrain company here at ACT Expo. Well, over the past 2 years, we actually made the strategic shift of moving out of building electric powertrains, going all in on stationary power gen, and it's through this KARNO technology, which we actually acquired out of GE Aerospace a few years back. So what applications are most relevant? So EV charging, data centers, we've talked about a lot. Waste gas, so one of the things I'm gonna cover is how this system's truly fuel agnostic. So you can actually take methane coming off of landfills, gas coming out of oil and gas wellheads, and run that right through the system without even needing to purify the fuel beforehand. The next is prime power, so think of just standard facilities, moving those to make your own power. And the real driver there is the low-cost nature of it, where you can actually make electricity cheaper than the grid. And then the last, which one we're pretty excited about, is we actually have a contract with the U.S. Navy to power future autonomous Navy vessels, which is a pretty neat one, and one where we're using actually liquid fuels, using diesel, to power those. So this is the technology. It's called the KARNO Core. It's this four-shaft system designed to produce 200 kilowatts of power, and it's structured as a linear heat generator. I'll cover a little bit more how it works, but you've got those four shafts. The benefits that come from it, I mentioned the first already, truly fuel agnostic. Now, most deployments are gonna run on natural gas just because that's the fuel that's most readily available. But we also have applications that are gonna run on hydrogen, on diesel, on methane capture. So we've identified over 20 fuels that this system can run on. Ultra low emissions, you can see some of the numbers there, but achieving single digit parts per millions of NOx and CO levels. So to put that into comparison, if you take a standard natural gas engine, a recip engine, our emissions levels are in the order of magnitude of like 98-99% lower than what a standard recip would be, and that's with zero after treatment system. And then efficiency is 50%. To put that into comparison, the US electric grid on average is about 36% efficient. So now you have the ability to make electricity on site more efficient than even the utility. And then low maintenance, only one moving part, as well as low noise. So we take the four shaft system, we package it in a closure with all the balance of plant, and that is what would actually be deployed at an EV charging site. Each one of those boxes producing up to 200 kilowatts of power. And then we are also working on a 2 megawatt variant of the product as well, which takes 10 of those four shaft systems, packages them together into a box that's about the same size as a 20-foot shipping container. All right, so let's now talk about how does this actually work. So it's based on a concept of Stirling engines. So if you go back 200 years ago, there were steam engines, there were reciprocating engines, and there was this thing called a Stirling, which most engineers knew this was the best way to make power. The problem was is that it was almost impossible to manufacture. So what we've done is we've said, well, what if we apply the latest and greatest in manufacturing techniques, AKA 3D printing or additive manufacturing, we can now actually make those really complex parts and bring forward a 200-year-old technology. So the way it works is on the outsides of the system, we bring fuel in, we react it to make heat. And heat is actually the fuel source of this power system. So that's what makes it very unique, is that we can get heat from anywhere, right? We can get it from natural gas, we can get it from hydrogen. And so you bring the fuel in, you react it, make heat. And then in the center area, we have a trapped gas. And it's helium, the gas inside. And what happens is when you heat that gas up, it wants to expand. And when it expands, it pushes the piston down one way. And then you do the opposite reaction on the other side, and you push it back. And then you have that shaft oscillating back and forth. And that's what's making electricity through a linear motor in the center. So the unlock of this technology, as I mentioned before, is 3D printing or additive manufacturing. You can stop by our booth and actually see these parts live and in person, but that's an example of one on the left-hand side. That's a heat exchanger within the KARNO. And then the machines on the right are what actually make those parts. So in our Cincinnati facility, as well as Austin, Texas facility, we have a very large install base of 3D printers that are sitting there running 24/7. Making the components that go into the KARNO. And then the last thing I just wanted to share is, well, how does this all stack up? So if you compare it on, you know, what customers care about the most, electricity, maintenance, emissions, footprint, and upfront capital cost, on almost all of those, we are near the top or at the top in terms of performance, but the only solution that really is able to bundle all those together into one product. And what most people care about when you're actually thinking about adopting a solution like this is the TCO, that payback, which while it does have an upfront cost that is higher, the actual efficiency of the system and the low maintenance nature allow you to have a pretty fast payback. So with that, the big story here is we need a lot more power. whether it's for EV charging, whether it's for data centers. We think the model is going to be a distributed grid as opposed to big power plants, and we see the KARNO generator as the way to make on-site power. So thank you very much, everyone.